My name's Joshua Little Ales, and you're listening to the Borough's brand new community radio station. This is My Tameside. Now, I love community radio because I get a chance to speak to people who you might not otherwise get to speak to, or if you're a listener here on radio. And today we're joined by Ray and Jody from Love of Lazy. Good morning, guys.
Hi there.
You guys are wonderful. I came into your charity shop just across the way on the corner there, and you're so lovely. And you're doing so much great work, and we are going to talk about upcoming events as the interview progresses. But I want to start with Lacey, little Lacey. A year ago, you was on a camping trip.
Yeah,
Where were you camping?
Not far from Halifax, it was. Lacey, it was one of her favourite things, one sit camping. So it was just a spur of the moment thing, you know, quick 4-day. Camping trip once it, so
something you was excited about.
Oh yeah,
a little family holiday.
Yeah,
it sounds lovely. But then Lacey,
yeah, it's a very rare thing. She became unwell. She just said, I don't feel very well. Within moments, she's collapsed to the floor. CPR was done for over an hour and a half, and that was it. She was gone in that moment. Now, it's put down to SUDC, which stands for Sudden Unexplained Death in Childhood. In a nutshell, that means there's no actual reason for her passing.
So it's been over a year since, and there's still no definitive
answer? Yeah, there's no definitive answer. That's why it's broadened to that thing. All the tests were done, and there is no answer. Maybe medical science in the future at some point might give us an answer, but for now there is no reason.
I just can't even imagine myself putting myself in that scenario. You must have been absolutely distraught because it's sudden, so you can't prepare for it. There was no sign of illness beforehand. And how have you coped?
Support from friends and family. It's the old cliche, and it is what it is. Without our friends and family, we probably wouldn't have got through it. But the support from the community as well has been massive, and that's in such a short space of a year. That's where we've ended up, where we are at the moment.
It's amazing how everybody comes together.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
The world is a great place. Yeah. I mean, you read the politics of the newspapers, and it seems crap, but really, the human spirit is alive and well, and you guys are proof of that. And you've started a charity organisation now called Love of Lacey. Have we got charity status?
We have got charity status now, yeah. It all came about not long after Lacey passing. A few close friends and family got together and they did a mini fundraiser, which at the start was supposedly to help us, but we didn't want that help. And the money raised, it was a gala ball, wasn't it? Which was held at Ashton Masonic last year. And they raised just short of £10,000. And that to us was not needed. So the idea came across that we could put that money to good use. So that's where the Love of Lacey idea came from.
And what's the goal with the charity?
The goal is we want to help other bereaved families. At one stage, we're hoping to get a retreat somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
For bereaved families to go away just for a bit of reflection time, you know, a bit of peace and quiet. Because both myself and Jody, when it happened to us, in that moment and a couple of weeks after that point, you just want to get away. It's like everything's closing, isn't it? So, you know, it'd be nice if someone would have offered us, you know, just go away for a bit, you know.
You said when I met you, it must have been a week ago or a couple of weeks ago, you said when someone passes away and you're trying to grieve, everybody comes around with flowers and seeing if you're okay. And you said, and it kind of hit me that, you said, what happens when everybody goes away and it's just left with you and Jody?
Yeah, that's right, because everyone was amazing for the two. I mean, everyone is still amazing, don't get me wrong, but for the first 2 or 3 weeks, you're inundated with people coming around your house, like you were saying, flowers. People seeing if you're okay, but people also have their own lives to get on with, you know, work, family commitments and so forth. So after that first couple of weeks, they're getting back to doing their own thing. Mm-hmm. And that's when it hits you, because you feel like you're on your own. Even though you're not, it's just that I suppose the help's there massively at the start, but then it just...
It's all the memories around the house as well.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, everywhere you look in your house, you know, you can just see, we could see Lacey sat there and, you know, playing about in the lounge and so forth. So it would have been nice to just a bit of, you know, reflection time somewhere else.
It's nice now, you're celebrating it. You must be grieving and you'll probably always grieve, but you are celebrating it and you've got this great cause. And how the hell do you find time to do it? He's sat here with his stagecoach uniform on. How do you find time?
You make time, I suppose. We've always been the same. Before Lacey passed, we're always the first people there to help anybody out. Friends and family will tell you that. So it helps us as well doing this, because we feel like it's Lacey's legacy, this. And knowing that we're doing something in her memory and to help others, it's a nice thing. It's nice to be nice.
I mean, there's nothing you can't do. I've only known you a few weeks, but you work for Stagecoach. You're helping run Love of Lacey. And you were Santa the other day.
Yeah, we still are Santa. I mean, you've been into our charity shop.
Yeah, it's lovely.
If anybody doesn't know where that is, it's on Stamford Street in Ashton Underline. Little plug there.
Yeah, no, go for it.
it's a charity shop, and we've turned one of the rooms upstairs into a Santa's grotto. So if there's any children out there that have not seen Santa yet, they're welcome to come in.
I'll tell you what, he must be the real McCoy. It's the most convincing Santa I've ever seen. I had to tug on his beard just to make sure he was real. Now, guys, you staying around for a little while?
We are, yeah.
Got a few more questions, and we'll plug some events as well, if that's all right?
No problem, yeah, thank you.
Here's the Beatles, Drive My Car. Welcome to your Feel Good Friday edition of Light Lunch with Little Ales. We're joined by Ray and Jody from Love of Lacey. Yeah. Now, I hear you guys are running a football team. I used to play left back. I wasn't very good, so I tried right back. I wasn't very good. Then I tried substitute. I wasn't very good. So then I gave it up. Then I carried the water bottles. Are you looking for a football player for your team?
Well, going off them positions, you should have been left back in the changing rooms, I think.
I give it a good go. I mean, for you guys, I'll come and I'll train and I'll pump up my own balls if I have to.
You're always welcome to any one of our games. Whether we get you on the pitch, it's another matter. We've got some amazing players.
I'll interview. Where do you get the players from? Are these friends of yours?
I've myself been involved in football since I was about 6 or 7, all the way through my life. And then just before she passed, Lacey got involved in football for about a month and a half. So we decided to create a football team, call it Love of Lacey FC. And every player that plays for that team, they're all close friends of our family. And we're unbeaten at the moment. And I think... Not just because they're all good players. I think it's because they play with that extra bit of passion.
Yeah.
So
they're playing for something.
If we find ourselves, you know, a goal down or whatever, they kick it up a gear. They're all awesome, all the lads.
And you're on the team?
Oh, yeah.
What's your position?
I'm the first picked.
Are you captain as well?
No, I won't go that far, no. Captains, Anthony Pugh, and our vice captains, James Elmo is known as. And we've got a player manager called Billy Gallagher. They're all awesome lads, though.
I mean, I'm going to meet these at some point, aren't I? Hopefully.
Absolutely, yeah. And well, you're welcome. We've got a game on Sunday. You're welcome to come down to that.
In Hazel Grove?
That's right, Hazel Grove Sports Centre, yeah.
Oh, it'll be busy Sunday. What time's it kick off?
We're looking for a 5 o'clock kickoff.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, God. I mean, it's a great problem to have. I mean, Willow Wood have got bits on Sunday and the Anthony Seddon as well. But if we can come, we will come.
Yeah.
I'll come with me whistle and support you.
Well, it's good. It's good, these football games, because in essence, it helps me playing, because what we're all playing for. But we're also raising funds at the same time, because we're a charity football team. Every team that we play against, they usually pay subs. So they normally donate money to our charity, so it brings everyone together. So if there's any other charity football teams out there or local teams, you're welcome to give us a shout.
I'm going to have a look. I'll be your promoter. It'll be like Mike Bassett, England manager. Is that what he's called? And we'll find you some games.
Yeah, that'd be great, yeah.
Love of Lacey FC. And you've got a gorgeous football kit.
Yeah, the kit's unreal. Jody designed that. It's
oh, you designed it yourself?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. You're a very talented couple, aren't you?
With a bit of help from Google.
Oh, Google. And is it purple? I'm trying to get my memory.
Yeah. It's a mixture of pink and purple, which was Lacey's favourite colours, but Newton Sports, who made the kit, they went above and beyond for us. And on the back, if you look into the actual numbers on the back, there's actually blended in pictures of Lacey in the numbers. It's just unreal. The whole kit's unreal.
I've never known anything like that.
No, it's
that was Billy's idea, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was the Billy's idea, the manager.
How do you find places to play? Because that can't be easy. Because there aren't just pitches just there available, are they?
A lot of emails.
Right. And you do that yourself, of course.
Yeah.
God, you guys are good. We need to get you to Wembley. How do we do that?
If you can do that.
Right, let me make
a
note.
I'll do an interview for you.
I've got my pen out. Wembley. How do we do? There's got to be a way to get to Wembley. Or at least the Etihad.
Oh, I'd love that, yeah.
Ooh. Are you a City fan?
I'm a neutral. We'll leave it there. Yeah.
Don't have a cat fight live on air, please.
I'm not saying anything.
No, you staying around for a little while?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll have a chinwag. You guys are gorgeous. I don't really want to let you go.
You too.
I mean, if there's anything I missed out, though, don't be polite. Just tell me, Josh, you've missed this out. We want to talk about it. Here's Bette Midler from Home Alone 2, Lost in New York. It's called Somewhere in My Memory. Then after that, once again, Ray and Jody. Good morning. Mercy. Duffy. Good morning. 32 minutes past 11. Couple of requests on the way. We've still got our superstars this morning, Jody and Ray from Love of Lacey. I've had events thrown at me. Are we going Blackpool? When we're going Blackpool, tell me about that event. Any excuse to go to Blackpool and get some rock?
Oh, you'll love this then. Yeah, we've got, it's organised, but a good friend of ours, Coco, that's his nickname, Coco, and he's got an amazing team behind him. He's organised, it's called Lacey's Ball, which is a big gala ball. Red carpet event, full three-course sit-down meal.
Ooh.
The full works, and that's at the Village Hotel in Blackpool on the 1st of February. It's £49 a ticket.
Not bad.
And if you want to book, you can go onto Facebook and look up Lacey's Ball.
Lacey's Ball. Will there be a link on your page as well?
There will be something. We're always updating, though, but we'll
try and post something.
There,
yeah, we should post something. £49, not bad.
Not for what you're getting, and they've got hold of some amazing prizes as well, up for auction and raffles and so forth. But the whole event, I mean, you can't go anywhere for £49 nowadays.
No, you can't. I mean, a frock's going to cost me £25. I'll get someone else to sew it for me. I'll get my auntie. She's a dab hand at that. That sounds great. That if we can come to that,
of course,
we'd love to come to that. Oh, yeah, that sounds wonderful. And we can buy the tickets online.
Yeah.
And they're available now.
Yeah, if you go onto the Facebook page, Lacey's Ball, you can access the tickets on there.
2020 is going to be a very big year for you guys. You must have so many ideas you want to come to fruition. But again, it's you guys. I mean, you've got a lot of work to do, but I think you're prepared to do it. Just out of love, out of sheer love.
Absolutely, yeah. The legacy is important to us, and with the help of friends and family at the moment, we feel like we're smashing it at the moment. So
you can
only get better as well.
It's like Babe Ruth knocking it out of the park. Now, guys, before I let you go, thank you so much for this morning, by the way. Tell me more about the Santa. How do we get to go and see Santa across the road?
Right, well, the tickets are £6 each. Walk-ins are subject to availability, but you can book. And also we're doing a new thing. We're doing personalised Santa messages.
Wow.
So you can give us a few details about your child or adult, if needs be. And for £3 or a donation, we'll do your personalised message from Santa.
Oh, God, no, I've never heard anybody do that before.
Well, if you go onto our page, Love of Lacey, I think there's a video on there of one already. So have a look, by all means, and send us a message inbox.
Oh, I would love a personalised message. My name's Josh, I'm 28, and I love cheese strings and Slinkies and Mr. Potato Head. Work with that, you're a magician.
Right, well, I'm Ray and this is Jody, so we'll have to have a word with Santa about that.
Oh, please. Well, put in a good word.
Yeah, we will do.
I've been a good boy most of the time. Yeah.
I'm sure.
Yeah. He doesn't believe me. Yeah. Guys, thank you so much for coming in this morning.
Thank you for having
us. Whenever you want to come in for a chat, just come in. You don't even have to book. You just walk in and then we'll just have a chinwag on air. We'll share whatever posts you've got and events coming up on our Facebook page as well. And I'll probably come across and see you later.
Welcome anytime.
Get
yeah,
the kettle on.
Thank you.
Jodie and Ray from Love of Lacey, everybody, thank you so much. Do you want to stay behind for a picture?
Absolutely, yeah.
Oh, God, I love my picture. Good morning, everybody. Here's Elton John, Step Into Christmas for Davo, and on the way as well, Stop the Cavalry, Joe Need a Louie, that's for Mel G.